Hi guys, this is me, Elliot Noah Thompson, and I'm here today with another video, if you have been watching my other videos. And today's video is going to be a little different because it's going to be a really long video because I'm going to be explaining how I got to the part of Oliver, and my mom's going to be prompting me with some of it. So in the end, we'll have to edit some parts here and there, so it's going to be a little, like, scratchy. So it all started a long time ago.
Can we get to the acting part?
You want to hear the part about how I got to be Oliver?
All right.
And it all started a long, long time ago. I've been watching The Lorax a lot lately. Yeah. Back in 2011, when I was only a year and a half years old, Warren Light was the executive producer of a show called Lights Out, and Pablo Schreiber was in it, my favorite, and so it was only one season long, but in 2013, Warren Light was the executive producer of Law & Order SVU, which I didn't watch, and he wrote a part for Pablo Schreiber, my favorite still, and I didn't watch that either. But he was a really bad guy, and one day my...
I'm just gonna pause it.
Oh, it's important to know that Warren Light wrote the part specifically for Pablo Schreiber, and we don't know what would have happened if he didn't, but the story continues. So now, at the same time, he was playing a not-so-nice prison guard in Orange is the New Black, and he had a famous mustache. And so, while he was playing a really bad guy in SVU and a really not so nice prison guard in Orange is the New Black, there was an interview, and Pablo said that he was the most hated man in America. And so Mom showed me a picture of him, that fabulous lady, and so she doesn't know why, she just did as she said. And so she asked me if that guy was a bad guy, and I said, no, that guy's a good guy, he's my friend. And so that was it for them. But a couple weeks later, I asked her to show me some more pictures of him because I've always loved bad guys, and in Frozen, I was so sad when
Marshmallow
got his leg cut off. Didn't he like roll down a mountain?
Yeah, he did.
Yeah, and roll down a mountain. And I was so happy at the end when he found Elsa's old crown and put it on. And so And so, didn't you like ask me what I wanted to?
No, you asked me if I could show you more pictures of that bad guy who is your friend.
Yeah. And then I kept looking at photos of him, and there was my favorite one, and Pablo was at a football game, and the Jets won, and he had his thumbs up like this. And I've always kept that photo under my pillow since I was 4. And so it was Christmas, and then it was New Year's, and I wanted to make a New Year's post for Pablo, and so I got it all set up, and
I didn't think anybody would ever see it.
And Mom didn't think anybody would see it, but sure enough, Pablo did see it. And isn't this the part where I said that I wanted to become an actor?
No, that was a little later. That was the next year, after you made more videos.
Oh, yeah. And yeah, I kept on making more videos for him, and like then for his birthday, or if the Jets won a game or something like that,
which wasn't very often at that time.
But
so the next year.
Yeah, but then the next year, I asked Mom if I wanted that I wanted to become an actor, and she said, okay. And she looked up where theaters are that are close to our house, and there was one that was just downtown from us. It was Valley Youth Theater, and I did my lessons for acting there. Wasn't it one little show?
Well, it was like an 8-week session, and you did like three or four of them.
Yeah, and so yeah, but Mom said there's Charlotte's Web that's gonna be going on, and
so seven by now.
Yeah, and I was seven now, and she said that if you wanted to audition for it, then you can, and I did, and I got the part of ensemble in there, and I was really happy about that. So and then didn't I do a video for Pablo that I got?
No, probably. You made all kinds of videos for Pablo.
So I probably did one. I don't know if I did. And so
and after that, you...
yeah, after that, I auditioned for more plays and got the. I was Baby Ruin, Winnie the Pooh, Christmas Tale. I was one of the Lollipop Guild and The Wizard of Oz. And
Ensemble for Madagascar.
Yeah, Ensemble for Madagascar.
And those were all VYT shows.
And those were all VYT shows. And then it came to January.
No, what? Richard.
Oh, yeah. Richard and Father Christmas and the Snow Queen.
At
Theater Artist Studio. And then it was January. And all the way from January through July, I didn't get any parts. And I asked Mom if seven rejections or no feedbacks or nothing.
No callbacks.
And I I said to Mom, I've gotten so many rejections, I just want to give up. So Mom talked to me about how rejections are what make you actors, and if Pablo gave up after seven rejections, he wouldn't be where he is right now. I personally don't know where he would be. So, So Mom asked me if I wanted to try out for A Christmas Carol, and I said sure, but Mom completely forgot about the opening audition, and she was just really bummed out.
So upset.
Why could she forget? And then they posted that they hadn't found their Tiny Tim yet, so Mom said that this would be perfect, and we got there, and there was this kid that I knew that was a really great actor, and I knew that he would get the part, but I auditioned for it anyway, and sure enough, he got the part. So, but we were, I'll get to that part later, and we were sad, mad, sorta.
I thought it was all my fault.
Really bummed out. If we had came to the opening night one, maybe we could have gotten it. But instead, there was this one at Mesa, in Mesa Encore Theater.
Which I had never heard of.
Which we both had never heard of. And so, actually, even though I said that would be my last one, I tried out for that one, and I got the part of Michael Banks, which I was really happy about. And at the audition, the producer?
Director,
David Chorley, said that he would give my mom an email that I would be in the callbacks. And I was there in the callbacks, and...
For the callbacks, you had to have the sizes.
For the callbacks, I had to memorize two sides,
it was two sides.
I had to have a British accent, which I have now, thanks to Sarah Storm, who...
Getting back to the Pablo.
Getting back to the Pablo part, she did a show with...
The bad guy that he was in Monarch.
The bad guy he was on trial.
And she
tried to... Well, she didn't think that he was...
Her character.
Her character didn't think that he, as his character, wasn't guilty, so she tried to help him get out of jail in the show.
But anyway, she's a voice coach.
She is a voice coach and an actress. And mom asked her because she followed her on something. Twitter. And so she asked her if she knew any resources for British accents. And since she was so kind and so loving, she took time out of her work to read it. What?
Sarah, that is not me.
Sarah. Took time out of her work to read my sides in a British accent.
Yeah.
And
give you a crash course.
Gave me a crash course. And so.
So
now.
Warren, Pablo.
Yeah.
Pablo and Sarah.
Yeah. Warren and Pablo and Sarah all together.
So now. Okay.
So now. I was Michael Banks and Mary Poppins, which is really awesome, and I was so excited. And then someone from my play in Mary Poppins was the co-choreographer and
for
Oliver, and she asked Mom if she was planning on auditioning for Oliver.
Not me auditioning, you auditioning.
No, me, yes, me auditioning for the part of Oliver in the play Oliver. And so I went to auditions, and I had to use a British accent for that too. Thank you, Sarah. And Dan Ashlock, the director, said, email Mom that I was in the callbacks. So I went to the callbacks, and when I got home, Dan called me. Well, he called Mom first, but he called me after and said that I got the part of Oliver, and I'm so excited. But on the 5th, 1 week away almost,
less than,
I will be opening for the play Oliver, and just I'm hoping that if you're not in the play, that you can buy tickets and come. And so, anyway, all of this to say, if all this didn't happen at the exact right place at the exact right time, I don't think I would be Oliver right now. And I don't know if you think someone is all orchestrating this or conducting this and after. But I do, and I would like to thank these people. Thank you, God. Thank you, Mom and Dad. Thank you, all my fellow actors, directors, choreographers, and musicianists. thank you,
Warren.
Thank you, Sarah Storm, so much. And thank you. Thank you, Pablo Schreiber. Bye. But wait, there's more. Don't forget to buy tickets.
I'll put the link in the comments.
I'll put the link in the
comments. Yeah, you put the link in the comments. I'll put the link in the comments.
Mom will. In the links down below, make sure to put a like.
Thank you. You're so weird.
And make sure to subscribe it to me and, well, Mom, but me. And make sure to follow Pablo because he is an amazing actor. I think that. I don't know about you. But
he is. He totally is.
Yeah, but, and I think that he deserves all the followers, whatever, likes, anything. But anyway, goodbye and buy those tickets.